All right, gang, we back, we back. Man, I don't know what happened, man. My computer just crashed. Like, it just crashed. I don't know why it crashed. It ain't got to do with no internet or none of this stuff. But we got to get back. We got to get back to it. All right. Now, look. Like I said, Livanova family is behind all of this. They perpetrated as protesters, organizing protesters. They was all on Facebook spreading narrative, bogus narrative about the case, so nobody won't figure out that they was, you know what I'm saying, in cahoots, right? So look, right here. Here go now. Here go Leonora people with the protest at Rosemont because they took their bull home. Look, watch this.
Serious fees. I got to laugh on this one.
Thank you. So say that the cannabis is yours.
No offense.
But that's illegal, so you can keep the cannabis because that's illegal. But my bullhorn is.
It's not a legal substance, a legal device.
In the act that he was arrested for. Therefore, it's kept as evidence.
Hey, where is that? Show me that in writing.
Can I show you everything? If you
right, they don't want to.
Hey, try to send that video through a Gmail. If it's a large file or something like that, you know what I'm saying? Contact me on Facebook. You know what I'm saying? You can send it through Facebook Messenger. And if it don't go like that, hit my Gmail, Trey Game Production, Gmail. You dig? Now look, here go Livanova folks at the police station talking about their bullhorn because you know they got their bullhorn. And that bullhorn is like a gun. It's like a weapon. Cause they telling on Crown Plaza. They talking about the cover up. You know what I'm saying? Then they already talking about the video finna be released. So the police took the bullhorn. And again, they down there, they already locked up the pastor. Cause y'all already know the same dude they were preaching at the funeral. That's him at Rosemont. They even locked him up. Look.
Sell us nothing. They don't want to sell us anything. They didn't want to show me the paper or the ordinance that I asked them for y'all locking me up for using the siren. They didn't want to show me
they're
that.
They're supposed to show you that.
Hey, bro.
They're supposed to show you. They're supposed to show you where it's been amended.
I won't listen. First of all, for evidence, so you were, what are the purpose of the evidence of the bullhorn being kept? Tell me.
Right. That's
it's
what I want
inventory to know. And documented that he was using it. It's kept until.
But well, James, I believe James is coming. I believe that's what he just told me. Whether you guys say
look,
whether you guys have said anything to me at all, I want y'all to know that I love y'all. I love y'all so much, and I will do whatever it takes to make sure that you guys know. Hold on one second.
Of course.
Now that's Livanova family right there, bro. There he go. This another Harris. I think his name Lonnie Harris, y'all. I think he's Linnell some shit. I don't know. But I don't know if he the cousin or the uncle. But he related to Livanova and got a whole lot to do with this. Check him out.
Oh, sure.
Even with the bond money, right?
Oh, I know.
Because y'all didn't have to post no bond.
I already know it.
What do you mean you have to post? We paid bond.
I know y'all did, but y'all didn't have to.
Because that was bogus. The lockup was bogus. The whole thing was bogus.
All it was they was going to give me a ticket and let me go. But y'all come with money, they took it.
I already know. That's why I want to see the watchman. That's why I want.
Is the watchman still coming?
They not going to.
Now, this just to show you how Santana this is. You got Livanova family at the precinct with the pastor, with the police. And remind y'all, the pastor was crying and talking about he getting threats from the hotel. But Miss Teresa didn't get no threats from the hotel, did she? Leonora didn't get no threats. See what I'm saying? Look.
He over it. He's not coming back right now. You know, he was here already.
Yeah.
For us, he is their watchman. But yeah.
So that's Charles.
Hey,
tell the people, thank you, Charles.
Hey,
thank you,
guys.
Hey, check it out, man. That's why they all saying they watching us. When they say they were watching us, they had us thinking like, yeah, they watching them. You know what I'm saying? They need to be trying to find out who did it to Kanika. And the whole time, we seeing the people that's involved, bro. You see what I'm saying? I seen him all on Facebook. He was at the protest, and I was like, man, that dude looked familiar. He even was on YouTube for a hot second. Not one time he said he was related to the family or nothing. It was all about, yeah, man, we just need to find justice for Kanika. So you already know he related to Breonna Garrett, bruh. So put this together, Breonna Garrett. Then you got him with the pastor. Come on, bro.
They wanted him to give his ID. Yeah, I told him, I ain't giving your ID.
They all should have did it, period.
I didn't give it to him.
I just wrote my name down.
They said they knew you guys. They came up here and said, Andre. No, they're lying. They already told me they knew who you were. They say they even knew you too.
Oh, they know how we are.
Oh, Jack Wild Dicker, his Facebook live. They be watching our lives, bro.
Oh, I already know.
They know who y'all are.
I already know.
They just trying to figure who I am. They know they done saved me plenty of times, but they don't know my name. They never know.
They know me and Charles. I mean,
Paya, you see how he talking too much? You see that? They trying to figure out who I am, you see. Know what I'm saying? Look.
They be watching our lives, bro.
Oh, I already know.
They know who y'all are.
I already know.
They just trying to figure who I am. They know they done saved me plenty of times, but they don't know my name. They never know
they
my
know
name.
Me and Charles. I mean, they know me
they
and
know y'all
Andre.
Names.
Yeah.
They don't know my name, so they just trying to figure out my name. And they kept on asking me, what's your name? I'm not telling y'all nothing. Oh, you know, well, you know we give you a what's the name? I'm like, so? I ain't gotta tell y'all nothing. That's obstruction of justice. I don't care. I don't have to tell you my name. Just
right,
like
they,
y'all
they're, they're
like y'all don't wanna show me
hey.
y'all city ordinance neither about the siren. So now they wanna keep the bullhorn and tell me, well, you're gonna have to come back up here tomorrow and get it, because we holding it for evidence. Evidence for
come on, bro. You posing as an activist? You posing as an activist and you trying to look, they try to make it seem like the police were messing with them. They so racist and they just, you know what I'm saying, just can't deal with black people. So let's get them. Come on, man. And the whole time, these the suspect got their cameras out, you know what I'm saying, for they safety. Like, look, we, you know what I'm saying, we gonna make it look like a bullhorn, but you know the real reason why we down here. You see what I'm saying? That's what that is, bro. That's why Leonora, when, look, put it like this, true. When you look at the protest, you will never see him around Leonora. He there, but you ain't gonna see him around the family like a family supposed to be. Man, Miss Teresa working this side, they working the other side, and you know they y'all in the crowd telling the people, yeah, you know they in the organ harvesting. You know this a cover up, right? You know that owner of the hotel, you know they whispering in the crowd. So the police already knowing, like, man, get them folks' ass out the crowd. Lock them up. out of everybody that got locked up at the protest, look who they all locked up. Lamont, Monifa, the pastor, P. Rico. And they made it look like they were locked up because they violated the protesting rules. No. No, they went to the police for other reasons, bro. You know what I'm talking about?
What?
For my bullhorn?
Yes.
Oh, no.
Oh, no, they can't do that. They're making up another rule.
See, they're making up rules.
Y'all hear that, right? They done took my
bullhorn. I gotta come back tomorrow to pick it up.
They just want to fuck with you. That's all. Excuse my language, people.
Okay, so let me ask you this. My bullhorn was with him. They cannot keep my bullhorn. Well, can you, whoever's down there, I need my property. That don't belong to him.
Exactly. And I told them that's not mine. They asked me. I said, that's not mine.
They can't keep it.
No, they can't keep nothing.
Hey, evidence or what?
Evidence.
I said the same thing. Evidence for what?
For me using it?
No, because they get your DNA off of it. You know what I'm saying, gang? Look at the gang they were running on us.
I said that's bullshit. They just want to keep somebody's shit. They already just trying to trick y'all out of that money that y'all just paid them. They already just trying to trick y'all out of that money that y'all just paid them.
That's all it's all about here is the money.
That's all they want to do.
Yeah, that's all they want, the money. That's it.
I was trying to catch y'all before y'all even came up here to tell y'all don't even come up here. I was trying to keep the bullhorn because they know.
Hey, we can't leave our brother in jail, man. Come on, man.
You're my homeboy. They didn't even fingerprint me,
nothing,
bro.
Oh, they didn't
mean. They didn't do none of that.
Oh, I didn't do nothing. Did they take a picture on their cell phone like they did me?
Yeah, they took a picture of me on their private cell phone. On their private camera.
Yeah, that's what they did to me. They took a picture of me on my private phone.
Can I have my bullhorn?
The bullhorn right now is being kept as evidence.
Evidence for what?
That's mine.
And this the same police that was standing in the lobby talking to Jedediah Brown. This the same police officer, bro. So let's remember what's some about the money.
They already told me they knew who you were. They say they even knew you too.
Oh, they know how we are.
Oh.
We know the police know who they is now. I know why he's saying it now.
Jack Wild Dicker. It's Facebook Live. They be watching our lives, bro.
Oh, I already know.
They know who y'all are.
Bro. I already know.
They just trying to figure who I am. They know they done saved me plenty of times, but they don't know my name. They never know
They know me and Andre.
They don't know my name, so they just trying to figure out my name. And they kept on asking me, what's your name? I'm not telling y'all nothing. Oh, you know, well, you know we can give you a what's the name? I'm like, so? I ain't gotta tell y'all nothing. That's obstruction of justice. I don't care. I don't have to tell you my name. Y'all don't want to show me y'all city ordinance neither about the siren. So now they want to keep the bullhorn and tell me, well, you're going to have to come back up here tomorrow and get it because we holding it for evidence. Evidence for what?
For my bullhorn?
Yes.
Oh, no.
They're making up another rule.
They're making up another rule.
They're making up rules.
Y'all hear that, right? They done took my bullhorn.
I got to come back tomorrow to pick it up.
They just want to fuck with you. That's all. Excuse my language.
So you got people thinking they at the police protest about a bullhorn, and they got people feeding this to the people at the protest, you know what I'm saying? And these people, they're on some more business, because look what he talking about.
Okay, so let me ask you this. My bullhorn was with him. They cannot keep my bullhorn.
I have no idea about that.
Well, can you, whoever's down there, I need my property. That don't belong to him.
Exactly. And I told them that's not mine. They asked me. That's not mine.
They can't keep it.
No, they can't keep nothing.
Hey, evidence or what?
Evidence.
I shouldn't say anything. Evidence for what?
For me using it? I said that's bullshit. They just want to keep somebody's shit.
Cause you ain't
trying to trick y'all out of that money that y'all just paid.
See that? Trying to check all that money, the money they just come on. What money?
Body shit. They already just trying to trick y'all out of that money that y'all just paid them.
But Charles,
that's all it's all about here is the money.
That's all they want to do.
Yeah, that's all they want, the money. That's it.
I was trying to catch y'all before y'all even came up here to tell y'all.
See, but look. Watch this. Y'all see, look at his face. Man, that man look just like them folk, bruh. Same nose and everything. That man look just like them folk, bruh. Livernora, Quelta. Then when you look, same head shape and everything, bruh. Let's go to Breonna Garrett. Oh, look. Oh, I gotta go to this Quelta. If that's not Kanika, then who that is? This look, there go another relative telling everybody that ain't even Kanika, bro. Right? Here go to Breonna Garrett. And look who Breonna Garrett look like. Kanika other cousin. You see this? Come on, bruh. In the beginning, we know that was the cousin. She admitted she was the cousin. But she claimed she don't even know none of the Martin family. Here go the video with Louis Chamberlain. Bruh. Cause y'all see how Kanika face look right here. Boom. Now this one, Chosen King was spilling the tea. Now this when Chosen King was spilling the tea, right? Watch this. This what he was putting out that we didn't even know. We ain't even know this in the beginning. she definitely was paid. Who called off the protest? Cause the hotel losing money. All of a sudden they got a Mercedes Benz and look, and parked it in the backyard, brand new. I don't see, look, these people saying she got a Benz and was parking it in the backyard. I don't see who with her. She still got to act normal, but she got a hell of a bread off this. Come on, bruh. Look. I believe she was paid, but they said she had a GoFundMe and other donations coming in. See, I need to go watch the rest of Chosen King video. It was too much. I couldn't register it all in one night. But for the people on here coming like X in the group, I think y'all mad extra. Like, who y'all working for? Who paying y'all? Cause y'all the one mad hype and ignorant to people who are just coming along asking any questions how you gain knowledge. The fuck? It's like one day I just looked up and touched based on Kanika case and I see Antonia name. So how I have to go back months of reading and research Kanika case and doing the same for Antonia Vet. I don't even have much info on this woman. No Facebook, more than 3 pictures, no nothing. You see what I'm saying? So, let me get to the good part. Look, she called out the protest because she had an order of protection against her. Now, keep this in mind. The hotel put a restraining order on Miss Teresa, not to keep her away from them, it's to keep her quiet. That was to keep her quiet. The whole time we thinking the gag order. No. So boom. She said it on her live. It's crazy, girl. Look. So people start screaming shots. So Miss Teresa called off the protest. Cause look what everybody was finding out. Just imagine, look what we know now. Now you see why they had to call. They had to call everything off. Again, she called it out because the order they put on her, she taking better, more privacy steps. Hold on, wait a minute. She clearly said they wanted her to stop because they was losing money. How they gonna lose money in 24 hours after the deal? You can might as well say 36 hours after that. How they losing money? Hold on, y'all. Let me get to the good part. Man, y'all see that, bro? Look. Now look, peep gang, y'all watch this. This when he finna expose Breonna Garrett. Look what he said. Y'all can't tell me Leonora isn't Breonna, ain't T. The pictures of the, look. That's why she look just like Leonora. See that gang? So what she did, she started deleting a whole lot of her Facebook posts that she had with Leonora. And he went over there and started screenshotting her to prove to everybody, look, this the Kanika lookalike that was in the hallway that night. You see what I'm saying? Look. So, boom, Chosen King hit him hard with this one. So, because he just exposed a family member. Man, them folk down there look like twins, bro. They look like twins. Look, yes, blood related. Yes, 100% related. And look who made the group. Marco Jones, another YouTuber, bro. And look what type of time they on. If y'all read the Bible, y'all know the book of Ezekiel tells y'all about the devil and how the devil bless you. Traced it back to Harris. Traced it back to Harris. Now y'all know about the Breonna Gary book and who wrote the book and all of that. Now y'all know why Miss Teresa was talking about that girl and Jedediah now. So y'all remember that book? This the mother. She tried to sue us because we told her about the rape victim that they wrote a book about. She know we have proof, so she is wolfing. But if she doesn't step back, we will open up and we will all know about her and her past tied into it all. The rabbit holes goes deep. You see what I'm saying? Now look, this her name. Look her up. Look, y'all see this? Ooh, so you mean to tell me that Breonna Gary is the girl they wrote about the book and the gang member was threatening, harassing the family? Look, so y'all don't read between the lines what Chosen King really just admitted to? He just admitted to, man, look, we the guys that was doing all that torture to y'all. We know you ain't gonna sue us because you know what's going on. And look, and guess who was on the case? Andrew Holmes. Oh, Lord. Oh, So that's why that dude on YouTube was saying, no wonder why they brought that book back to the light, because that's dealing with Leonora's side of the family. Oh. That's why they would start rumors like Miss Teresa, that ain't Leonora, is not Miss Teresa's daughter and all of this stuff, because look what Breonna Garrett. The situation, look what's coming together. Bro. What they just say? But that's Leonora's sister. Leonora and Teresa is not related. Man, bruh. Yeah, look. So, look, this is what I'm getting out the deal. Cause if you pay attention to Miss Teresa and Leonora relationship, you would think that's her favorite daughter in the world. So then you tie all of this Breonna Garrett stuff with it. Now you see why they got a type look. You see what their mother and daughter relationship is really, really about. So the whole time when we were thinking family member, maybe it wasn't on the Jenkins side of the family. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? It's looking like more on Leonora's side of the family that did it this. Because Miss Teresa wanted to change Kanika Martin's name to Kanika Jenkins. Because I was like, why would it change? Because it changed on September the 9th. It changed on September the 9th. Round 2 something in the morning. Now since I know who did it, because I know who got the phone now. So look, boom. Check this out. Miss Teresa at court. She hollering at Larry Rajaneel trying to get that money. That lady trying to get that money, gang. God, I knew that Breonna Garrett case had something to do with the Kanika Jenkins case. Because it sound like somebody in their family, bro. It seem like somebody in their family, bro, is a serious rapist, bro. And he terrorizing family and everything. Because you got living normal with a baby, bro. An incest baby. You see what I'm saying? Man, we on Miss Teresa and them ass now, gang. We got them now. Cause I could never tie the Breonna Garrett case with the Kanika, cause look at that story. It's the same setup. It's the same setup. So they use little girls. They pulling leaks at teenage kids' party, bro. It's like they had a teenage girl throw parties and them niggas come in there, Johnny, terrorize. You see what I'm saying? Golly. Look, P. Rico exposed Teresa and James Coleman in August. Oh! wonder why King Rod used to always talk about what he'll do to little girls and stuff. He was open about that. Bro, I told y'all P. Rico was trying to expose. But I bet y'all ain't go find that video no more.
No one time out.
Damn, y'all good at for what y'all keep good up the good work. Teresa, pull up the tube, drain your juice. Your team is shrinking. Later, we'll be singing the blues. Golly, bro. Golly. So, if the police... Look, make it so bad the police know about the Breonna Garrett case. Because I was just looking into it like last month. Because I just talked about it. Make a long story short. The people that did it, right? The people that did it, they ain't even get charged for it. They still let him on the loose. But just told her, look, we just going to relocate you. You know what I'm saying? We just gonna relocate you and you can stay with another family member. You see what I'm saying? So they wrote a book about it. So it was exposing how men's, well, how they be setting up these girls at the underage parties. You know what I'm talking about? And how you got these friends that be in on the setup. I guess that's the new back door thing in Chicago, bro. Cause that's where a lot of they back doors, that's where a lot of they back doors come from, is house parties. Yeah, they said they had to put her in protected custody. Then look, they even said they was getting harassed by the same people. Yeah, they got the Facebook Live, all that stuff, bro. So that means the police know who behind it and they know Kanika family is, look, they know that it's socially related to Kanika's side of the family. You know, they got cases filed, so they actually know what happened. So that means Miss Teresa and them ain't no stranger to law enforcement, bro. You see what I'm saying? Miss Teresa ain't no stranger to law enforcement, bro. You see what I'm saying? Look. And then look, that's why they probably pushing this Antonio and Vet Evans. Once you think about it, Antonio and Vet Evans with the Breonna case, right? And the police said Antonio and Vet Evans is still alive. Cause I looked at Katonio and Vic, because you know what King Rod and them were talking about, they were family members. They were going to the police, said, we some kin, that's our people, and we trying to locate them. So if you look at the Breonna case with that and this, bro, you finna open up a whole nother can of worms. You finna open up a whole nother can of worms, Nat. Let me keep thinking. Cause this is too much. Man, this just hit me like a straight boot in the center of my forehead, bro. Cause it's like everything clicking now. So look. So Chosen King was spilling it. So boom, what's this here? Oh, they was talking about the funeral home was switching bodies in the casket. You know, they had their little one thinking they were burying their little one and coming to find out it was another woman. Now look, this one thing I found out about, because this finna expose the funeral home. Now, the people that did the funeral home that was associated with the Kanika Jenga case, they got caught switching bodies at funerals and stuff. You know, burying the wrong person and all of this. You can look this up. It's about 2-3 funeral homes. They all connected. You see what I'm saying? And they all did insurance fraud, got caught organ harvesting, selling body parts, and all of this. If you look it up, you will find out. That's why Miss Teresa was calling Zach and exposing about the pet cemetery. Right? Now it's clicking on me. These people got a pet cemetery. Right? I believe that's where a lot of things go down. At the pet cemetery, because nobody ain't looking at a pet cemetery like, you know, they don't just really too much think about a pet cemetery. But if you watch the movie Pet Cemetery, you'll see what I'm talking about. Y'all seen the movie Pet Cemetery? Y'all seen that movie? That scary movie? I know y'all seen Pet Cemetery, bro. Look what that movie is about. You see what that movie is about? You know what I'm talking about. Look. So boom. Look at this, bro. She ain't too, look, she ain't too far off looking like Kanika, bro. Look. Bruh. So what did they got their daughters into? Cause it looking like their mother got their daughters into some wild crazy things, bruh. I don't know what Miss Teresa and them got going on with these little girls, bruh. But they got something going on with these little girls. So, boom. Hold on. So that's why she did this. Look, gang. Now y'all understand why she made this video right here.
Now this man got me all over his YouTube talking about I'm a clone of Kanika, all on my page showing all these crazy white people my pictures and stuff. Do you know how, talking about where I live at, do you know how many molesters and all type of crazy people it is out here that's really gonna sit right here and believe you because you think you know what you're talking about?
You heard what she just said, bruh. Now you think about the book, what was written about her as a teen. You see what I'm saying? Cause she fit right in the same age bracket, bruh. Look, watch this.
Do you know how, time out where I live at, do you know how many molesters and all type of crazy people it is out here that's really gonna sit right here and believe you because you think you know what you're talking about?
You mean to tell me, she said, you think all these molesters on here are gonna believe you? What? You know that girl messed up in the head, bruh.
How am I a clone of Kanika and Kanika is 18 or 19? I'm 16, finna be 17 in January. I've had a whole 16 years of life before Kanika even died. What would the government even get out of cloning Kanika? What would they get out of cloning Kanika but more problems? Then he gonna say, I'm a clone of Kanika, really, because I got a butterfly tattoo on my stomach. Oh, you know how many people got a butterfly tattoo on their stomach? That's the first tattoo every black girl get when they come of age to even get a tattoo, when they allowed to get a tattoo.
Look, I see why they use Monifa, bruh. Look, I see why they pointed the fingers at Monifa, because they just don't really mess with Monifa like that. They don't mess with Monifa like that, bruh. I see what's exactly going on now.
Like, you sitting right here showing all these, y'all, I shared the video on my page if y'all want to go watch it. Just listen to this man, like, he sound delusional. These people so delusional, really thinking that I'm a clone of Kanika, like a whole clone. Like, I'm really her, like the government made me after she died. That's what these people really believe.
Tell that motherfucker spend that much time and effort into making some.
There go the mother. He exposed the mother. Look.
Money for himself or doing something productive with his fucking life. Tell him spend that much time to find a way to change the motherfucking world instead of some stupid ass conspiracy theories. Last time I checked, I popped her about my pussy. What the fuck is wrong?
Period. Straight from my mother. Like, y'all, he really pushed it with this YouTube stuff. And then it's people coming to like,
put me back on live. I'm cute, girl.
Girl move. Like, then he really pushed it, like, showing them my whole page, scrolling through my whole page, showing them my pictures, my Facebook name. Tell me I deleted all my videos off Facebook so people can find me. And all this, just this crazy stuff, y'all. And these people is commenting on the video. I shared it on my page if y'all want to go look at it. Crazy stuff, y'all. And these people is commenting on the video.
You didn't tell the world that you were related to the family. You didn't tell the world why he really put your picture out. You see what I'm saying? Now I see why you deleted all your stuff. Cause people started noticing, like, boom, you know what I'm saying? Cause they would have dig deeper. If we would have found all this information out in the beginning, man, that lawsuit would have never got, you know what I'm saying? That lawsuit would have been out the door, gang. Instead, if it would have been a check on the table, it would have been a warrant for all day arrest. So that means the police already know they little scheme, what they got going on with the underage girls, and they using their own kids. These Miss Teresa and these ladies who are using their kids, bruh. And And look, and we already know she was molested by a family member, bruh. By a family member. That's why she had to leave the house and go to other witness protection program, bruh.
Video like, yes, she's a clone. Yes, I've seen her Facebook page. I'm following her now. I don't give no flat F-U-C-K. How many of y'all follow me? I will follow y'all. I don't care. The whole Kanika universe can follow me. I do not care. I am a real person. Not, we don't have the same birthday. We're not the same age. We don't even look like, really. On one or two pictures, we look alike, and now all of a sudden, I'm a clone. On one or two pictures, me and Kanika look alike. And now I'm just Kanika. If y'all don't sit down, this is just too much. Then y'all got people inboxing me, talking about, wow, I'm running. Do I need a lawyer? I don't need none of that, because I'm trying to tell y'all, y'all come to my house, so many people gonna end up dead. So y'all play that role if y'all want to. Tell me how y'all finna come find me and et cetera.
And I believe it when she said that, bro. I believe it when she said that, bro.
So many feelings are going to be hurt. I promise you. I'm a whole person. A real life person.
So.
Now, she puts this message up. All these strangers on my page from out of state study saying I look like Kanika. I understand all that, but get the F out of here. Okay, so if you don't, then why you deleted all your videos? Huh? I came on your page yesterday. You had like 40 videos on here. You deleted every single one except for this right here. Oh, shit, let me mute that before they try to get me. You deleted everything except for this. Come on, man. What are you doing? What are you doing? What were you running? Brianna, are you running? Matter of fact, let me send you a message while I'm on here, man. Why are you running? I know some stuff. I'm gonna ask her, is she part of that program, that cloning program? That's what I want. I want to know why you got the same tattoo as Kanika, the butterfly tattoo.
But look, watch this. This is the crazy part about it. Watch this, gang. Check this out. Since we talking about her, where you at? Where you at? Where you at? And where you at? That's why Planet of the Faith was on them folks. Look. Hold on, where you at? I don't tell my past to John. I passed it.
That's where her body is. It wasn't taken in. The spirit said you would think this was Photoshop, but she said no, it's the body there. Look, it's
right. Here we go.
Aren't my friends that I spend time with and that who post on my.
Here she go on. Look, even Crenshaw found out where she, look, even Crenshaw found text messages with her posted with Liv and Nora. Look.
To talk about who we are dealing with and explain to you why I've grown to change my mind on this family in general. So, first off, this case is very serious to me. It always has been. It always will be. It is no joke or no laughing matter, which she typically goes by. I have found some other aliases of her when she was much younger on different sites.
Watch this. Hold on. Look. Watch this, gang. Right,
and we're going to start with Mama. Now, Teresa, or according to Ancestry.com, was born, I don't want to mispronounce it. So what is this? Teresa Vade Martin. As you can see underneath in parentheses, it's Teresa Sarah Martin, which is, you know, what she typically goes by. I have found some other aliases of her when she was much younger on different sites, but the Ancestry.com one that states it, that's was on the, you know, it's a birth record. It is her birthday, as you could see. So, I mean, this is her. I don't know quite what that last name's about. I also just wanted to bring out another thing I've been saying and I've been finding interesting is that when I research her on this other site, these are all pictures. I even left the time on the top from my phone so that you guys could see that I took these pictures all at the same time. They're all from the same, from Family Tree Now and Teresa's information. You could research it for yourself. It has her name there, and I find it very odd that I don't see her children here. When I just searched for her under Teresa Martin, Leonor does come up, but that's the only child of hers that I can know of for sure. But who does come up in her report is Sierra Croft. For those of you who have not seen my first video, I talked about Sierra Croft.
Now this finna get real. Look, cause this finna get real interesting, gang. Cause look, guess who Sierra Croft is? Look, gang, this finna make you think. Croft.
I talked about Sierra Croft, and I went so far as to say that she was the girl in the surveillance tapes, and I found it odd that I could find her associated with Teresa, and I can't even find Kanika associated with Teresa. For those of you that don't know what she looks like or remember, there she is.
Bruh. No, I'm talking about, hey, you ain't lying when you said that, Richard. I swear this weird crime story in the world. Cause what is about to reveal to me that somebody running a foster care. And it's like some of the victims is foster parents, and you know what I'm saying, and they got a scene going on with missing kids. That's what I'm looking at. If you looking up, if you want to look at this case, like if they are part of organ ring, this how they getting the bodies. This how they getting organs. You see what I'm saying? This what they mean about a cloning program. You see what I'm saying? That's what I'm exposing. Cause when I told y'all, I said, man, if you can go and look up some of these missing person reports, look how many of them associate around Kanika, bro. And I ain't even know this. Look, if y'all would stop, look, I can stop this live right now. I can stop this live right now and tell everybody, go right now and look up the missing person cases on the website and count how many, do your research, that's associated around Kanika, meaning it could be Kanika friends. She know these people. Look. That's what King Ron was telling and Chosen King. He even told y'all, yeah, we snatched these kids up. Taking kidneys. Look.
I was going to say the one on the right, but in my personal opinion, she's the one on the right and the one on the left. I've yet to find anyone else it could possibly be. And by now we should all know that it has been proven by so many people that the girl in that surveillance tape and in this particular video is that we're not dealing with Kanika in this picture. So let's move on.
She could have been Ball Balls. She could have been Ball Balls.
From this and go to Sierra Croft featured on Leonor's Facebook. These are some clips that I've taken from Leonor's Facebook page just recently. The clips aren't all recent, but I recently took these, so they're still on there if you want to go look and find them for yourself.
Y'all know what I'm looking at now. Leonor, the real setup queen. Leonor is the real setup queen. Leonor, bruh. All the evidence pointing toward Leonor and Miss Teresa were riding with it. Leonor planned it, the whole thing, how it was gonna go down. You see what I'm saying? So y'all, look, if y'all saying what I'm saying, then so y'all mindset just like mine. You see what I'm saying? Cause look, you see when we following the paper trail, we done follow the owner all the way back to teenage girls. You know what I'm talking about?
You can see right here, Sierra Croft on her Facebook page. She goes by Tyshawn Mommy. So that's why I blew this one up at the bottom so that you could.
Look, you could tell that's the only way they could set Kanika up. Is get her around family member, because Kanika never kicked it with nobody that wasn't family, bruh. That's the only way you could get her if all her cousin them, girl. You see what I'm saying? So Leonor gonna set it up for what they known to be doing. Throw parties. Look, we gonna do it at a party, you know what I'm saying? Put that in a drink. Boom, she knocked out. Boom, come on. That's why Leonor was all on the news. How was her hair when she laid out, when she left out the room? And ooh, it looked like it was a struggle. She like my sister was fighting and stuff. And yeah, when we went down in the freezer was warm. And look at all that. Well, she had to say all of that to cover up for this girl, bruh. For her cousin.
Can see she does actively comment on Leonora's statuses, so they're, you know, they're close, supposedly related, who knows? I don't know, but she's definitely, they're definitely friendly, if you will. I came across a few other things that I found to be very interesting on Leonora's page as well. This is a post that Leonora posted on April 20th, and it says, you know, she tagged Abrianna Mays and just said, yes, thanks so much, baby. Why is that important? Well, for those of you that don't know, Abrianna Mays is none other than the infamous Bree Bree, the Bree Bree from the hotel room that night, the Bree Bree from, you know, just one of the friends basically in the room. There was Irene, Bree Bree, Shamaya, and Monifa. So I didn't realize that they were friends. Maybe that's weird, maybe it isn't weird, but look at this. Leonore Harris shared Shamaya Winder's post. Mommy baby Yodi twin. Yodi's her baby daddy, and then Shamaya had originally posted it. And this goes all the way back to 2016. And there's more posts like this, but I'm not gonna go over her entire Facebook page. I don't have that kind of time. Obviously, Shamaya and Bree Bree and Cece are all close to Leonore. Is it a coincidence? Some people are going to say that, and they're going to believe that, and you know, everyone's entitled to their opinion. But I think it's weird because I have younger siblings, and I don't. Their friends aren't my friends that I spend time with, and that who post on my timeline and like not like this, not like where, I mean, like, this is clearly people that she is friends with. I find that kind of odd because of the age gap, if we even know, you know, the real ages. But if you're still not convinced, I totally understand. I have a little bit more that I want to show you. Now, this video is not going to be about narratives. My next one will be a lot of narratives. But
now look, here go the search warrant and stuff, right? Look, they had a search warrant. Look who they got on the top of the police report. Leonora further stated the last time she was in contact with Kanika through a text message at 1:30:99. Leonora Harris also stated she received a Snapchat video of Kanika Jenkins at 2:17. And Leonora further stated that approximately at 4 o'clock in the morning, three of Kanika Jenkins' friends, including Monifa, was with Leonora Harris at home with Kanika's vehicle. They drove to the party. Woo! So, if you look at this like a confession, just say Trey got a detective and I got Leonora. So, I broke her down, right? And next thing you know, so you is and me, you talked to Kanika, yes? And you knew she was dead, yes. And you had the phone, yes. And you were contacting Monifa, yes. And you was perpetrating that you was Kanika, yes. Did they know they wasn't talking to Kanika? Yes. Did they know about what you did? Yes. Was they was a part of it? Yes. You see what I'm saying? So let's go to Monifa. Since they pointed fingers at Monifa, and Monifa was set up to, to, to take the blame for it.
Right?
So only thing Monifa had to do, just agree with that you left her in the hallway on the night. And this is what Monifa did. Right? This is what Monifa did. So boom. Then you got Miss Teresa talking about she got the call at 4:34. How will you get the call at 4:34 if they at the house with Leonora with the car? But Trey Gang put the investigation together. Cause this how they got the car. The car had to still been there since the 6th all the way to the 9th. So when you read Bree text about who was going, about her driving, she didn't want to drive with the car, with the donut on the car. You see what I'm saying? That's when they got the car back. You see what I'm saying, guys? That's when they got the car back, bro. And they try to make it look like we just going to tell them we was about to leave. And that's when she came up missing and Bree Bree had to end us driving us home. You see what I'm saying? That was the story. Now, that's how they thought they were going to get out of the way with that. So, boom. Monifa stated they arrived at room 926, 1130. And at 1:30, Monifa stated that she arrived at the hotel with the Hennessy bar. Coming to find out in the investigation, they never went to the liquor store. They never went to the liquor store. Then they told everybody, everybody came from out west from another party to go to Irene party. So everybody had a party on the west side and everybody went to the setup.
No, I'm talking about.
So look. So boom. Only thing Monifa had to do, just say you the last one with her and left in the hallway and we'll take care of that from there. So boom. Right? So y'all can read these documents. So boom. So when you get the text, look. Boom, boom, boom. Look, you can tell what's even on Shamaya, man, because she in there talking about niggas' penises, bro.
But I do need to read to you just a paragraph from a very important narrative, and we'll discuss it. It starts off saying, Leonore Harris further stated, the last time she had contact with Kanika Jenkins was via text message at approximately 1:30 on 9/9.
That right there can evict you alone.
2017. Leonore Harris also stated she received a Snapchat video from Kanika Jenkins at approximately 2:17. Now, I mean, there's more. That's even more.
So if we prove...
Shut up.
So we prove Kanika died before the... If we could prove that Kanika died before the night, right? And we could confirm that. If we confirmed it, that means this information right here showed that Leonora knew and had some dealing with the night and Kanika Delbra.
Incriminating, but we're just going to talk about that. We're just going to focus on that one line. I want you to remember this, okay? I want you to remember that she said the last time that she had contact with Kanika via text message was at approximately 1:30. Okay? Now, I'm going to bring up the text message. And this is something that I cannot believe I overlooked in the past, or any of us for that matter. This is the text message thread that I brought up. I brought it up in my last video, and I'm sure that you guys have seen, you know, this text message thread a lot by now. It is Kanika's actual text message thread from her phone that Rosemont Police released. And again, the timing is in UTC, so that means for Chicago, you do need to subtract 5 hours. There was one text message that Kanika sent from her phone. Actually, if you, at 6:20 is, you know, subtract the 5 hours, that it was actually 1:20, which would be approximately 1:30. And it says, "I'm ready to go." When I was reading the report, I got the chills, because she was texting Leonor. That's who she was texting. The whole time I was thinking that it was Monifa, and I thought it was odd because a person responded 30 minutes later, and I thought that was weird. But you know, how are you going to be in the same room and you're going to text someone and they don't respond for 30 minutes? You know, that it all makes sense. She texted her sister that she was ready to go. If someone says, "I'm ready to go," usually they want you to come pick them up. Maybe Leonor was already there. I mean, from all the reports, she seemed to already be there in all of these reports, but I'll go into all of that later.
Told y'all Leonor was gonna be there.
She texted her sister. Now, why is that so significant? And why do I say things like Leonor tells on herself? Because once again, let's go back up to this just one more time.
That's why the employee said they never saw Kanika coming in the hotel or leaving the hotel, because she didn't come in the hotel and leave the hotel on the night. If she showed up days earlier, don't that make sense?
Leonor Harris further stated the last time she had contact with Kanika Jenkins was via text message at approximately 1:30 on 9/9. Okay, get a good look. 9/9. I'm ready to go. Now, got a little video I want to show you guys. For those of you that are ready to jump in my comments and tell me how horrible I am, let's listen to this.
And she had a nerve to have purple on, purple flags, telling this story.
Were you the one who spoke with your sister about when Thursday before Saturday morning? Or no? Somebody, one of your family members spoke with her at 1:30, right?
No, I know she doesn't. People said you had it there on Friday.
Yeah.
But Saturday morning, there's a report that somebody spoke with her, at least knew that she was alive at 1:30 on Saturday morning. Is there any confirmation that you know of from that?
Right. I get a very bad feeling. Almost as bad as when I was searching Teresa Martin to see if she possibly had any other Facebook pages. And again, this could just be a coincidence, but I came across this. The clown. The evil purple clown. And the writing in the top corner, which references bastard. Bastard being the only word she has spoken on camera where she showed any kind of emotion. We all know it was very forced looking. And this is total, you know, just a coincidence, I'm hoping. But it's stuff like this that just creeps me out. This creeps me out just as much as that video of Leonor saying that she doesn't know what that reporter's talking about. She hadn't even spoke to her sister. She just knew that she left the house. And for those of you that are wondering about this page, assuming that someone, you know, just made it after the whole, you know, all of this happened and That isn't true. Go look this page up for yourself. It is on Facebook, and it was opened up. It was months and months before Kanika died, which is that much creepier. Let me get off of this picture right now because...
Yeah, make sure I show y'all. This is the profile. I don't know who these kids are, but that's who they uploaded. And there's May 22nd.
So.
And there's, this is the profile. I don't know who these kids are. But... That's who they uploaded. And there's May 22nd.
So, I just want to clear another thing or two up really quickly. Let's talk about the obituary. Now, I understand that there's a lot of people that have a lot of different, you know, speculation and things in their head. Like, they're saying that Kanika isn't actually dead, and that
make sure I show y'all. This is the profile. I don't know who these kids are, but that's who they uploaded. And there's May 22nd.
So, I just want to clear another thing or two up really quickly. Let's talk about the, or anybody, unless you are immediate family member, an immediate family member, or if you have, I believe that the site said like, basically, you know, if you're representing the family, or you're a family.
Man, look, look, I don't even like this bituary. Cause look how she look what the last word Miss Teresa said. My baby, my little baby girl, mama love you. Peace out. Come on, bro. That sound like an old drunk. All right, my little baby girl, mama love you. Now, peace out, Jack. That's how I'm getting the vibe.
Family member. That goes for anyone in that state, in that county. You can look this all up for yourself. Don't take my word for anything. Don't come in my comments trying to tell me how I'm wrong unless you have done the research, because I have. I have not spoke on anything. I have not given time, effort, energy into researching. So let's just throw that out the window about she can't be dead because we can't find her. No, the only, if Teresa chose to show us her death certificate, which she probably won't, provided, you know, that is her birth mother.
I'm telling y'all, bro, Miss Teresa ain't gonna show the death certificate. And you know why she ain't go show it. You see what I'm saying? It's not fair, bro, that lady living her best life off Kanika, bro.
No, I'm talking about, hold on, y'all.
Look. Look at this, bro. Look. Bruh, them folk, man, them folk really did it. They really did it, bro. Them folk really, really did it, bro. Man, that's cold. That is cold-blooded. This is crazy to me, man. That's crazy.
But that's kind of up in the air on whether or not what hotel they were at. Because I'm under the impression that the Rosemont Hotel pool is indoors. And the Marriott Chicago.
And look, this is what Kenny Tottenham was at on the night. You see what I'm saying, gang? That's why they gonna be at another hotel, bro. You see what I'm saying? That's why Kenny Tottenham gonna be at other hotels with the same people that was on the footage days earlier. So you know who paying for all of this, bruh? Somebody paid for all of this.
Chicago hair pool is outdoors. So we need to look into that. But if you look right back here, you can see the patio door. And if you watch the video, at 5 minutes and 49 seconds is when they start coming in that patio door. Okay. The lady behind the desk, from my understanding, her name was Yasina Garcia, okay? And we've looked up a couple different profiles, and when I was going through some profiles today, trying to look for the lady behind the desk, I came across this. Now, I don't know if this is...
Now, look, if you pay attention to in the beginning, right, y'all, these people said they didn't even saw Kanika coming. Y'all remember when Leonora was telling everybody what the hotel was telling them? They talking about they ain't even see my sister come in the hotel. They trying to say she never came to the hotel, right? So at that time, I'm like, man, why would the hotel say anything like that? Man, them folk got something to hide. But what if there was some truth to it? Because if you got Kanika coming up there on the 6th, right? If you got Kanika coming up there on the 6th, and you got the mother up there talking about her daughter was missing on the 9th, so these people going to look on the 9th footage, try to find her, and they ain't going to see nothing. You see what I'm saying? They gonna tell them folk, man, I don't know what you talking about. We ain't see her coming in. You see what I'm saying? And then when you think about the whole investigation, you seen a Garcia, the lady, that's the one that discovered Kanika on the footage and told the police where she was. So if you look at what she was doing, she must have had to went back 3 days or found the file or what they were trying to hide, bro. You see what I'm saying? So now you got staff members. That's why Miss Teresa said they wouldn't have seen it. You know what I'm talking about? They wouldn't have seen her. How they wouldn't have seen her and they got video footage? You know what I'm talking about? Oh, yeah, then you know Miss Teresa got a blue check mark on her daughter, Dev. Hollywood gonna make sure she get a check mark because she want to be famous, bro. You see what I'm saying? Look, You seen the Godzilla found Kanika on the footage. So that means, look, so when you seen the Godzilla come find her on the footage all that day, but happened to find Kanika on the footage around 11 something on the night. How did she locate that footage? Cause if it wasn't there all day long, how it mysteriously pop up and she found it? You see what I'm saying, gang? So Livernova tried to make us think like, man, these folks trying to say my sister was never at the hotel. And that's gonna throw, they're gonna throw us on the hotel, like, yeah, y'all goddamn it trying to say she ain't even showed up and all the dude. Star and mold distraction.
The same person as the person I showed you yesterday. But I think it's odd that the Yasina has an S instead of a C, and now it has two S's, and the last name is now in front. Now, there's no pictures, there's no anything on this profile. It's just as you see it right now. So that's another thing to look into. And this is just the profile picture blown up. Okay, here's a TripAdvisor. Let me turn my phone. TripAdvisor of the Michelangelo guy, okay? And if you look on here, Los Angeles, California, that matches up, September 29th, he has his name as Manuel S, which I thought was kind of odd, but not if they're using all these different fake profiles. He states that he recently stayed at the Crown Plaza and had a nice stay. The hotel rooms are big and spacious, but a little dated. There are several restaurants and shops within walking distance and free shuttle services offered, including pickup from the airport. The staff was nice and friendly and recommended. I'm sure a lot of people would argue the fact on the staff at this point, but I wanted to point this out. And I think it's kind of odd that it was in September, and he also works there. So that's another red flag to why he would be posting a positive comment to push out.
And y'all see how it's leading back to California. Ain't that's where Friends K went? Ain't that's where Kilo Brown went? And that's where Jess 33 Kings went. And then Miss Teresa take a trip to Los Angeles, California.
Positivity towards all the negative comments. Here we go. Okay, I saw this on Facebook. It's on Tay Zonday's page. And it's basically stating,
now look, y'all remember what Tay Zonday said? Bruh, this really finna get deep, cause y'all remember Tay Zonday told everybody, somebody saw her, said, man, the police were there on the 8th, bruh, and they was all at the pool area, you know what I'm saying? They had kitchen clothes down. You see what I'm saying? Look, she even sent the email to the police. And the police said, we received your findings and we appreciate all your hard work. However, that Kanika and Witness Protection Program, as you know, this is for a good reason, to not disclose any full information on it. If you wish to still continue to find it, we will answer your question if asked. You know what I'm talking about? So look, watch this, gang. We could sum all that up. If you want to find out that if a person is still alive or deceased, you got to find freedom of life. Freedom of life is like they gonna have to provide proof, but they can't give you no details about that person, though. You see what I'm saying? Just say if Kanika was still alive, they gonna say, yeah, Kanika's still alive. You know what I'm saying? She doing well, and you know what I'm talking about, and just don't want to be bothered with the public. You see what I'm saying? So look,
This Taizan they doing, right?
We received your findings. I appreciate all your hard work. However, that Kanika is in witness, that Kanika is in witness protection. Have you guys ever had those phone calls where, I know I get them every day, when people call and they're like, we're from the IRS and we're here to give you grant money. Bullshit. The IRS isn't going to call you over the phone. Okay, you can barely get a hold of them when there's an emergency. That's legit. Let alone, if Kanika was in protective custody, one, you would think that you'd be able to spell her name right. And two, they're not going to tell anybody that she's in witness protection. And I'm not saying that's anything against Tay Zonde. I'm saying that this is bullshit. That nobody is going to tell somebody that they're in witness protection. Okay? Now, I received an email with probably 10 to 15 photos, and it was labeled Crown Plaza Conspiracers. However the hell you say that word. So I'm going to go through this, and if you notice, he looks like a cartoon figure, okay? So I don't know if this is an added image or what, but I want you to notice that, because I think this is the only picture that I got that actually looks like a cartoon besides the one in my other video.
That's the dude, look, that's the dude that Miss Teresa was telling Zach about, the dude in the stripy shirt. The dude in the stripy shirt. Everybody need to find out who is this dude, bro. Who is him?
Amazing. And maybe it wants me to go the other way here. Let me see. Okay. I'm going to try to get close. You see this older gentleman? Looks like he's in charge of something at the hotel, and then the guy behind him. I think they were under the impression that that is David Friedman, the ambassador of Israel. I don't know if they messed with the photos, because David Friedman has more hair than that. I have a better... See, he has way more hair than that. So I'm not too sure if that... From the other photo, of which... they stated could be Daniel or David Friedman. He doesn't have the gold name tag on his jacket. Okay, now this looks like a younger kid, but like he actually looks like he's pregnant. Emblem on the shirt. So I'm wondering if that's some type of like or later fall. Or if this is a...
And here go in the paperwork, they list the handyman. Mitchell, handyman in Chicago. Listed him as a victim in the Kanika Jenkins case.
You see what I'm saying?
Watch this, y'all. I don't even think Kanika stepped in room 926. Because she was already there on the 6. And they booked the room 926 on the 8. Well, on the 7. They really booked room 926 for everybody to be in, bro. You see what I'm saying? So Kanika never was in room 926. She was never in room 926, girl. It would be impossible for her to be in room 926.
The murder mystery, did this somehow get thrown into Rosemont's public safety thing, and this is who they were trying to find that got murdered in the mystery? I looked up that company and it does exist. wouldn't let me go to the next one. Give me a jacket with me. But it doesn't make sense to why everybody looks like they're dressed for later fall than the 70 degree weather that it states was in Chicago during that week. And then here's creepy person again, which I'm also under the
look, if you really think about it, they ain't even if you really think about it, when we talk about the reenactment, you know what I'm saying? They really don't got to do the reenactment if you going to release the footage of them in the hallway. You see what I'm saying? Look at it like this real. When we thinking of a reenactment, we looking at the footage, like, you know what I'm saying, of the them roaming the hall. Now, some of that footage, you see what I'm saying, could be on the 9th mixed with the 6th. But what I'm saying in real time, on the 9th, actually at 1-something, we don't know what they were doing. Because at 2-something, you would still be thinking about Irene live video and all that old stuff and TY live video. You would still be thinking that was on the 9th, and you would still be thinking she's leaving in the hallway. Because right now, if I ask you right now what happened to Kaniga, the first thing you're going to say, man, she went to room 926. Her friend set her up. And this thing, you know, they left her in the hallway by the elevator. They snatched her. You know what I'm saying? You're going to go with all of that. What they created for us to come out with that narrative. It sound good. It sound believable. And you know what I'm saying? And that's what the people going to go for. They going to go for that. And you know what I'm saying? Because we ain't going to give them the truth. You see what I'm saying? Because if you really think about it, on actually the 9th, what's really going to be going on the 9th, really, you just going to see a lot of police officers, detectives, walking around the hotel, pointing at cameras. You're going to see people, you know, come on, bro. That's what you're going to see. Hell, you might even see the feds in there. Look, it probably got the point that the feds probably got in. You look, the feds probably would. Look.
Impression that maybe they have a mask on this person. Or maybe he played Mask in the movie with Cher back in the 80s. Because I've never seen anyone look like this. It's kind of hard to see, but if you look, go to the profile, do whatever you need to do, or take a screenshot, above his eyebrows looks like it's photoshopped. Like, he really does have hair, and they photoshopped this photo to make him look different.
First off, man, I want to address the naysayers. All y'all I know believe she did not die on the 6th.
See that?
Listen to all.
Look, what was Kaniga on the 7th and 8th, bro? Man, Chosen King hit him so hard. What was Kaniga? You don't got no proof for Kaniga was alive on the 7th and 8th. Because you know Mitch Reese and them got the farm on the 7th and 8th. That's where Living Over and them come from. With the farm. You want to go to the show with the hood tonight? You see what I'm saying? But let Miss Teresa tell y'all. She left the house at 11:30. That was the first lie Miss Teresa told. Look.
Alright, listen to Chosen King.
Alright. First off, man, I want to address the
the naysayers. For all y'all that don't believe she did not die on the 6th, yes, it is. What was she on the 7th and 8th? I challenge y'all to provide me a tweet, my video from her that's not altered or fake, or somebody's being out with her on the 7th or the 8th. As much as she had, as much as she liked to take big pictures and she's photogenic, she had to be doing something on those 2 days if she was alive.
All right, well then,
now listen to this, y'all.
Are you sure you don't mean the Crown Plaza and Rosemont?
Yes, so Carl, yesterday is, I'm sorry, the Crown Plaza and Rosemont, that's exactly where it's at.
No, it's okay. And have you spoke, and you said you spoke with the,
So, what if Miss Teresa is at the O'Hara Airport, and was that where she meeting up with the police at? Cause she said that's where exactly where is at. She didn't say that's where exactly where I'm at. Yeah, I'm right here. Yeah, I'm at the hotel. Yeah, in O'Hara. She said, y'all, that's where exactly. That's where is it? See that guy. That's why Miss Teresa said they want to see her, even though they got footage and would show her. That showed you that Miss Teresa already knew that Kanika didn't walk in there on the night. You see what I'm saying, bro? She knew these people weren't gonna find Miss Teresa. That's, look, she knew these people weren't gonna find Kanika on no surveillance footage on the night. She read the wrong ticket. Cause you could hear her fumbling with the paper in the bag when she realized she read the wrong ticket. Look.
Did you hear what she said? Do y'all hear that?
Real quick, I'm just gonna see if maybe she was here at all. What's your daughter's name?
Her name is Kanika Jenkins.
Okay, no, it's okay. And have you spoke? And you said you spoke with the
front desk. I'm sitting outside, right in front of the hotel in a parking lot right now.
And they were saying that they haven't seen your daughter since she left, or.
She said they wouldn't have seen her because it's 3-4 in the morning. See what I'm saying? Look, they let you know she at the hotel because she was like, it's okay. It's not 12 yet. Thanks, cuz. What your ass getting pretty in? That orange jumpsuit with that. Somebody made that on the 13th. So when they were making a post, this was at 10 p.m. that night. So that's at 10 p.m. that night, then all the comments stop on that.
Look at this, man. Oh, first we're going here. Let's hear it again.
You hear him? He's breaking it down.
I just seen this thing. She was here because I just stopped the ticket where they entered this hotel. It was at 1:36 p.m. So hold on, this podcast, because this is on 6.
Irene Roberts, September the 5th. She says, I can't wait to get pretty. All right? Then somebody said, I'm so sorry. I thought I said happy birthday. Happy birthday, babe. Enjoy. At 10:16 p.m. on the 5th, guess what Irene said? It's okay. It's not 12 yet. Thanks, cousin. I love you, too. So when 12 o'clock struck, which was going to be September the 6th, it was going to be Irene's birthday. Do y'all see what a piece is falling?
Yes.
It happened on the 6th, y'all. The reenactment happened
on the 9th.
But people who've been following my channel, following my videos, and watching them with the right perspective will know this. Also, I want y'all to see this. Scroll up. More proof for the tattoo. If I can make that larger. I don't know if y'all can really see that, but just go on the page, you'll see it. More proof for that tattoo to the right, man, of the navel. But her birthday, Irene's birthday, was on the 6th. That's when they went and turned up. That's when the original killing happened.
Wow.
They don't say it when I roll up. The things that people say about me, they don't.
Now I understand this whole interview when Kilo Brown got to talking about Kanika. Now look, check this out. Now I understand this whole interview when Kilo Brown was talking about the Kanika Jenkins case and who she had beef with in the Kanika Jenkins case. Look.
They don't like when I comment on things.
I shouldn't have said that. They're gonna.
When I say something, they're like, "You from St. Paul? Like, you give all these. You get when you say stuff, you got all the clout in the fans. So you give people room to chime in on when you say shit. And when you say fucked up stuff about us, it's like, man, that's not the point here. The point is like, we just gonna always be for real. And I be for dead ass serious when I got something to say, and they don't be liking that. And I'm not the friendliest. I'm not the bandwagon. You leave it to St. Paul. They can't stand me. So, like, so many people had a story of their own.
Y'all know who she talking about in St. Paul, right? Y'all know who she talking about in St. Paul. And y'all know she been shot and shit.
Look. You getting shot.
Yeah. Let the bitches tell it. I lost half my face. My face fucked up, because I got shot in the head. So, but they didn't know what I looked like. Didn't nobody see me, so nobody knew what I looked like. But they going around saying that it was a drug sale going around. I was in. They said the best story I heard was the cartel, the Los Angeles cartel, was after me.
Sheesh! You could have ran with that one.
Now y'all see how he's going back to California?
Bruh.
There you go. It's back to California, bruh. Look.
One. God damn.
They said the cartel was after
Matter of fact,
me.
Let's cut that part and just say the cartel was after me. That's the story.
Here we go.
I like it.
The cartel was after me.
That's a great story. God damn.
Let them tell it.
So the cartel was responsible for putting that girl in the freezer.
Yeah.
You told the story and then they came to get you.
The cartel came to get me because I'm a hustler. So, you
know? Oh my God.
Y'all just heard that. What? Look.
God damn.
Let them tell it.
So the cartel was responsible for putting that girl in the freezer.
Yeah.
You told the story and then they came to get you.
The cartel came to get me because I'm a hustler. So, you're all,
you know? Oh my God. That's crazy.
I'm a stepper. So.
So I could imagine your inbox probably looks crazy.
Bro, she just told you everything you need to know. You see what I'm saying? She just told y'all, man, look, he said it's the cartel that's responsible for putting Kanika in the freezer.
Let's cut that part and just say the cartel was after me. Yeah. That's the story.
Here we go.
I like it.
The cartel was after me.
That's a great story. God damn.
Let them tell it.
So the cartel was responsible for putting that girl in the freezer.
Yeah.
You told the story and then they came to get you.
The cartel came to get me because I'm a hustler. So, you're all,
you know? Oh my God. That's crazy.
I'm a stepper. So.
So I could imagine your inbox probably looks crazy. Do you even look at it?
I do sometimes. I do be fishing. Like, I ain't gonna say, like, look. That's why my cousin, she was just laughing at me yesterday. Because she made a post. And she like, go look at it. I'm like, damn. So I'm looking for her in my news feed. And I'm like, bitch, I'm gonna have to put you in my search bar. She gonna say, what? I said, I don't like putting people in my search bar. Like, I said, I don't search nobody up. I don't look at y'all. I know. But if you don't pop up, I don't care to see it. Like, I don't care. So,
damn.
I'm picky like that. But I do got my tools infused of people who I follow and that I go to look on their stuff. So, yeah. But
I didn't know you got shot.
Oh, no, this St. Paul. They so dying to know why I got shot, how I got shot, what happened, and all this and this and that. The cartel. Remember, the cartel was after me.
El Chapo himself.
So let them fucking tell it. I'm in a bunch of shit. So, and it was like, I didn't know him. I never seen him before or nothing. He just reached.
Y'all know, I know who exactly she talking about, bro. Look, I know who exactly that she talking about, bro. She laughing and joking about it because the nigga locked up. So y'all don't know who she talking about when she naming the cartel. Now look. Put it like this, even Straight Drop had the manager them calling him and telling y'all about the cartel. You see what I'm saying? Look.
Reached out to me.
Mm-hmm.
So I didn't even know he had like interviews or doing things like that. But he was like, you know, he came to me like he was putting, like he wanted to me speak on it and all this and this and that. And I thought about it like, what am I gaining getting on your show telling my story to these people that don't know? These people, like, what the fuck? No. Like, we in two different lanes and lines of things. So.
Yeah.
And I didn't think that he really was tuned in. Like, I just was like, you know, you're not tuned in to me for real. Because mm-hmm. you immediately say you wanted to interview me for my story. And I'm like, what's my story? And he like, oh, well, you got shot. If that's all you know about me, you ain't been around long enough, player. Because everybody know who the fuck he is. Like,
I mean,
like enough. Like,
yeah.
My name rings a lot of bells in a lot of places. So it's like, you ain't been around long enough if you're going to say, like, my story to you is like, oh, you got shot because... People been following me forever. I done learned parts of the world that I didn't even know existed due to my followers.
I was going to ask you that. Like, what is having amassed this amount of followers? Like, what is that? Are you able to turn that into monetary gain somehow? Are you able to find ways to?
I've been trying to get my YouTube monetized, but I don't. It's so hard. Like, nobody wants to show me how to do it. I've been trying to do it. Like, when I first tried myself, I think I messed it up because they had like an ads in account.
And look, and guess, and check this out. Y'all heard what she said about the AdSense account? I'ma show y'all who own it. Watch this.
Like nobody wants to show me how to do it. I've been trying to do it like when I first tried myself, I think I messed it up because they had like an AdSense account or something.
AdSense, yeah.
So I don't know. I think I had messed it up. And at the time I had hooked it up to something that I don't even have no more. Information I don't even have no more. So it was like I messed that up.
How many subscribers you got?
On YouTube?
Yeah.
Like 10,000 or something.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's why Scray dropped, boy. So that's why she made this video. You see what I'm saying, gang? Bruh, this is. Alaya. So look, man, y'all see how Leonora pulled it off? Y'all see how Miss Teresa pulled it off? If y'all believe these folk guilty, look at all the receipts that's on them folks. You see what I'm saying? Bruh, that's so messed up, bruh. And then look, Miss Teresa ain't studying none of this shit, bruh. Man, this lady ain't studying none of this, bruh. I can't believe, bro. You know, man, the J4K community really lost. They really broke it and divided us, bro. Look, they really broke us down, bro. Man, they won. They got it. They got away with murder and ain't nothing we could do about it, gang. Them folk really finna turn up on us now. Cause the more look, man, y'all, the more we be sitting up here, man, the better life they have. I don't like that, bro. That makes me mad, bro. Ain't nobody turning up on these folks, calling this lady out and make this lady like me. I don't get it, bro. I just don't understand. You know, sometimes I just wish social media never existed. Cause maybe people have their minds again. Cause you know what I'm saying? Back in the day, we used to have to think for ourselves, bro. Nothing was just handed down to us. You know what I'm talking about? Man, you had to think and figure things out. Now, these days, you don't even think no more because everything right there in front of you. You see what I'm saying? Bruh, man, look. I bet you y'all got a phone and I bet y'all can't even go in the contest and without looking at the number. And remember the number. Man, look, if you lose your phone and all your numbers in there, Man, you ain't gonna know who to call because you're gonna be like, you don't even know their number. Man, you gonna have to hit them folks up on Facebook. You gotta see a picture 9 days. You know what I'm talking about? I remember when we was coming up, we didn't have Google Map to show you when somebody gave you an address. If you didn't write it down, bro, you had a good goddamn memory. Look, you had a good memory. I remember people like, yeah, come over there to the house. And you know what I'm saying? Yeah, what's the address? Boom, boom, boom. How I get there? Yeah, once you look. Back in the day, this how you get the address. Hey, I stay at 5959 West Wing. All right, how I get there? Look, you come down up, you know what I'm saying, Jumanji Green Lane. You're going to take it all the way down about 5 miles. And you're going to come up to a road called Higgins. So, look, you're going to see a Sheraton gas station. Once you come on, you're going to make that left. You're going to go 5 streets down. Once you go 5 streets down, come up 2 streets. Make 1 left, another street, make a right. You see what I'm saying? Then you're going to have to remember all of that. You see what I'm saying? Now you got a map there to take you straight to your location. I'm talking about, man, that's where you... Because back in the day, look what people did on their time when they had no phone. Look, before cell phones came out, look what people were doing. People was at the house. You know what I'm saying? You were intermingling with people in real life. You sit down, you talk, you sit down and have a full conversation. You can see that person. That person can see you. But on social media, bro, you talking to a person through a computer screen. And then some of the people you might be talking to might don't be the people you think you talking to. Sometimes I just want to make a little fake account and pose me as a white man, and I'm finna join the KKK, goddammit. Look, I done fill in the application to be a detective. Them folk called me back and told me when can I come in. They said they looked at my resumes and shit. They said you know what I'm saying, I'm the perfect man for the job.
You know what I'm talking about?
Look, I ain't even gonna lie. I been working undercover for another case. I just didn't told nobody about it because it was G14 classified. No, I'm talking about. Look.
Y'all see what I'm saying?
Look, bruh, I put in the application at the police department. And you know what I'm saying? Because I had fabricated all my credentials and stuff. Because they was like, man, you got 18 citations. We never heard of that record before. It's like a perfect record. So they was like, man, we need him on the job. So look, they put a file on top of my desk. They sent me the email with like, look, we got a suspect and we need you to talk to a witness. You know what I'm talking about? So I was talking to the witness and stuff. When I was talking to the witness, so I told the witness what he looked like. You know what I'm talking about? Tell me what he looked like and I'm going to draw a police sketch of him. So when I draw the police sketch of me, it gonna help with the in case. You know what I'm talking about? So this was my first case, y'all, when I did my police sketch. You know what I'm talking about? And they gave me recognition on the news, but I told them don't, you know what I'm talking about, reveal my identity and stuff.
Hold on, y'all. Let me show it to y'all.
In Lancaster, Pennsylvania, we're asking people to be on the lookout for a man who robbed a store. And I think, yeah, I think we do have his description. Can we take that? Let's take his description.
Now, this is what the lady described to me. You know, I time out. The lady told me what he looked like because he went up there and he was holding up the store. So I couldn't see the video because the video was grimy and stuff. So I'm like, man, why the video grimy? So I had to be like, look, just tell me what he looked like and I'm going to draw the sketch.
Okay. This is the guy they wanted people in Pennsylvania to be out on the lookout for. He's got he's got a nose and some hair that goes like that, and he was
Now, I ain't the best in the world. I just did what works for me. You know what I'm talking about? I just did what works for me, gang, but it got the job done.
He was wearing a hat at the time of this particular crime. It's got kind of a chin that comes down to almost a point. Stands about 5 feet, 4 inches tall. There it is. Get a good look for yourself. Oh, and now I'm getting word that police actually caught this guy, thanks to the sketch, no doubt. So,
you see what I'm talking about? Bruh, I told that man, look, I told them folks, I said, man, look, this him. They were laughing at me in the office. I'm like, bruh, this him. I know he probably looked like, Charlie Brown a little bit, done grew up, but goddamn, though. You said he had freckles, you know what I'm saying? Little hard lines in his face, you know what I'm talking about? Say he had a payout hat. Look.
Oh, here's a picture of the real guy next to the sketch that led to his arrest.
Where's the pointy chin?
But they try to discredit me, though. Look, you see how fast I nabbed them, right? And I'm all the way in Lancaster with this shit, bro. Them folk came and hit my Gmail with like, Trey Gang, man, we've been following you for a long time. We need your help. It been a liquor store holdup, you know what I'm talking about? He and he dangerous. We just don't know who he is. So I talked to Susa Maybelline, and Maybelline was like, look, the nigga chin small, know what I'm talking about? He got crackhead eyes, that his head big as hell, you know what I'm talking about? You see what I'm saying? Look.
It's uncanny, Lisa. the guy on the left is now charged with 2 counts of theft, is being held in the Lancaster jail. And I say, give that sketch artist a raise.
That's what I was trying to tell him. Them four poser gave me a raise and everything, bro. Look, what they did, they had me to nab him, took him to jail, and told me they didn't need me no more. And, you know, I'm like, well, how I'm going to get paid? Because, you know what I'm talking about? I did draw the motherfucking sketch. Because y'all said y'all had a $50 reward out for anybody that can, you know what I'm talking about? And they told me, no, the money go to Susan Maybelline, you know what I'm talking about? And she talking about she ain't even got her money. Yeah, they were laughing at me, you know what I'm talking about? I was like, man, look, I'm going to get their ass back, you know what I'm talking about? Yeah, I'm in that junk. They passing the sketch around laughing, you know what I'm talking about? So what I started doing, I was like, man, give me the keys to the police cruiser. Took that junk around the block and started doing donuts. When I got through with the motor knocking in that junk. Look, they gave me my own office and everything. You know what I'm talking about? Then they showed me where they keep all the cush at. They were like, yeah, Trey Gang, who go to the locker room? Who go with all the cush shit? I'm like, damn, but God. Man, that locker room stayed loud. So what I did, look, them folk were like, look, I was at work and I'm like, yeah, I'm working overtime, you know what I'm talking about? So that, so I had to sign up for overtime. But when they came back on the next shift, they were like, who cleaned up the evidence room? So they were like, what you do with all the drugs? I'm like, y'all said shit, you know, all this, y'all holding for evidence and stuff. And y'all were like, y'all were going to throw it away anyway. So I threw all that shit in the garbage. Now they got the feds, the SWATs, looking for a big ass garbage truck on the way to the dump site. You know what I'm talking about? But I got all the drugs hidden in the car. You know what I'm talking about? Look, I got all the dope. Look, you know, my gal be mad at me. You know what I'm talking about? I be coming in the house, leaving all my police sketches around the house and shit. You know what I'm talking about? Baby be want to do it. I be like, not tonight, boo. This goddamn case weighing on him. I need to find him now. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, I told the police chief. I said, yeah, I got some information, man. You know what I'm talking about? I got to go undercover.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, they had me working this kingpin drug dealer. You know, they want me to nab him. So they were like, what you going to need? I said, man, I'm going to need a cutlass sitting on 28s with some bump in the trunk. You know what I'm talking about? I'm going to need all the Air Jordans. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, I'm going to need gold rings, chains, and all this shit. And a couple of big booty holes. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, so you know they gonna have they gonna need a real budget fucking with me. Yeah, so yeah, make sure you have, you know, to give me a trap house. I need a trap house. Yeah, then I need a family too, you know, to make it look good. So give me a wife and some kids, you know what I'm talking about. So yeah. So next thing you know, they got a picture with me and the drug dealer. Look, they like, Trey gang, give us a call. Let us know when you ready us to come in. I ain't like, I don't hear none of that shit. I'm like, hold on, not yet, not yet. Look, I forgot my microphone was still on. You know, they heard me, you know, they gave me a write up because they heard me telling the dope man, let me hit the kush. Now they want to drug test me cause they think I'm a liar, like I'm just lying. I don't smoke no kush.
You know what I'm talking
about? I remember I showed up for work one time, smell loud in the motherfucker, and the boss came to me with like, we got to talk. I'm like, man, look, I'm gonna be real with you. I know I smell like dope, but I don't even smoke it. I was in a dire need to, you know what I'm saying, to get her. And this thing, you know, my neighbors and them was sitting in the yard and they was in the car smoking weed. And I ain't want to jump in, but I thought about my job and I said, I need to get to work. So they brought me her on cloud nine, Jack. You know what I'm talking about? I ain't telling my hit it. I just said, look, they was smoking. You know what I'm talking about? And you can look me dead in my eyes, you know what I'm talking about? You can tell I'm straight, lying like a motherfucker. Shit, got dope all on my chest, you know what I'm talking about? He got buzz sitting on your chest now.
You know what I'm talking about? Yeah.
Then somebody snitching on me, talking about they see the police cruiser parked at Shay Shay house at night.
You know what I'm talking about?
I got sick of being the police. It ain't just for me, bro. Cause the murder rate, so I can't even get no sleep. Phone ringing like a motherfucker. Yeah, here I go. You know, soon I get in the house like, honey, I'm home. Ring, ring, ring. You got another murder case. I be tying them young niggas, bro. It's like a trap house now, you know what I'm talking about? I'm working one murder case. Look, I get a call. Yeah, come down here on 59th and Norman Street. We got a shooting. On my way there, I got other people calling me. Yeah, come over here too, because we got a body over there. I'm like, God damn. So they get mad at me when I stop calling in sick and shit. Like, man, look, I can't come in. Paying the doctor off. Tell them folks I'm stressed out over here. And I need some Vicodin. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, prescribe me all kinds of shit. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, that's how that I found. Look, cause look, when they had me working patrol, we pulled one dude over. I went to the car. He was one of them old school dudes. You know what I'm saying? Had the fishnet jersey on with them little bit ass tennis shorts, leg big as, got some big ass thighs. They greased up with a big ass motorcycle gang mustache. With an afro, goddamn it. Look. Caught him rolling weed up in the car. Look, he got chest hair, nothing but cushion and chest hair. Talking about I'm fucking with him. Cause people like, I'm like, bro, we get a call, y'all rolling dope up in here, bro. You know what I'm talking about? And I be tired going on no domestic calls. Showing up and shit, you know what I'm talking about? Now the female out there cutting up, you know what I'm talking about? He out there, the first thing he finna do is lie to me.
You know what I'm talking about?
I ain't finna believe nothing he say if his girl got a big ass booty and she need assistance at that time. Man, I'm finna manhandle your ass in there. Man, you said he did what, boo? I couldn't be the police. If your ass got a big ass booty, big breasted, full lip, big bone motherfucker, and you got problem with that nigga, I'm on the way. I'm coming in the house, cause you know them niggas, you know, cause you know when they see the police, they gonna be wanting to tell their side of the story, act like little, you know what I'm talking about, little punks.
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about.
I'm gonna punk his ass out in front of this gal. You know what I'm saying? Hey, bro, get your hand out your goddamn pockets. You hear me talking to you? Yes, sir. Shit. Yeah, do I got to come back out here? Hell no, you straight. Is I'm gonna have any more problems out you bitches? No, we good. You know what I'm talking about? That's how you gonna have to talk to me, cause I'ma demand my respect.
You know what I'm talking about?
Man, I'm gonna be whooping niggas all in the interrogation room.
I ain't gonna have that job long, bro. You know what I'm talking about?
I'ma have so many people write me up talking about they been tased in the ass.
You feel me, man?
I'ma have about 100 motherfuckers saying the same shit. Man, that nigga done tased me in the head. The judge gonna be like, man, look, you got 100 people saying this shit. This shit got to be true. I'ma have all of them in court showing the tase wound on the cheeks. You know what I'm talking about? Spread your cheeks, nigga. Show the world what I supposed to been doing. Why you sitting up here trying to, you know, show everybody, look, he tased me right here. And they're pointing at his ass. We laughing the whole time. Me, the judge, the prosecutor. You see that boy went on that stand. You see that boy double cheeked up. I said that boy booty one that bitch. I hit that boy with a taser. That motherfucker stayed swole for weeks. Had that boy looking like Miss Parker from the back. That's why I couldn't be no police. I know where to hit you with that taser. I'm gonna make it look like it was an accident. Look, don't let you already be on the ground. I'm be running towards you while the other police trying to subdue you. I'm gonna fall right on top of your ass cheek with the taser. And I ain't gonna stop pulling the trigger till I smell ass. You know what I'm talking about? Just to let me know I'm frying me a nigga tonight. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. Shit, I'm the only one showing up with work with boxing gloves on. You know what I'm talking about? Boxing glove, you know what I'm saying? And a bottle of energy drink.
Man, it's finna be a long day, bro.
I'm going straight to the hood. The police gonna be like, man, Trey Gang, he got to be naturally born for this because he know where all the drug dealers at. It's only two locations you're gonna find me at the drug dealer location and at the whole house. Yeah, I'm working undercover at the whole house prostitution ring. I'm trying to buzz all the Johns, you know what I'm talking about. Yeah, bro, I'm dead serious. Man, y'all got my eye watery hell over here, bro. I need to pop this drink over here. This is what I need to do. Yeah. But yeah, gang, I'ma get on now. I just wanna show y'all my first police sketch. That's how I got it look. They fired me after that one. They were like, we don't need you no more. We don't even need your service no more. But they kept my sketches. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. My girl didn't know who I worked for. She thought I worked for the CIA.
You know what I'm talking about.
She thought I was the Fed because she didn't know what I was doing. She know I was working with the government some kind of way. She was trying to piece it together.
You know what I'm talking about. But
Trey Gang, love y'all, man. Y'all be cool and y'all be safe. And we'll be back tomorrow around about the same time. And we'll pick up where we left off yet. Hopefully I'll be organized, you know what I'm talking about, so I can present my case more better and stuff.
You know what I'm talking about?
But if y'all, man, if y'all know what I'm talking about, appreciate it, like and share, and subscribe to the channel. You know what I'm talking about? You know what y'all be waiting on, you know? I'm trying to get back in that algorithm, man, and shed that light on Miss Teresa now.
You know what I'm talking about?
But pie, y'all. Man, Trey Gang, love y'all. Y'all be cool and y'all be safe. And I'm out.